The caller on the line, can you hear me, please? Your name and where you are.
Good morning, Mazi.
Good morning.
My name is Kenneth Nachuku, calling from Germany, from Bremen, Germany.
Your name is Kenneth. I want to know your proper name. That one you're answering is a Danish name. It came from Denmark. Okay, what is your proper name?
My name is Umunna Nachuku.
Very good. Umunna Nachuku, thank you very much. Named after heaven itself.
I'm calling from...
From where?
Thank you, Mazi. I'm calling from Bremen, Germany.
From Bremen in Germany. It seems only Germans are awake this morning and those from Texas as well. Yeah. Please go ahead, you're listening. Go ahead.
Yeah, Mazi, I just came back from work this morning, so I have to wait for your question and answer.
That's
right. So, Mazi, I just have two articles for you this morning, and I hope it will not be so difficult to explain them to me.
Right.
One important thing I want to say is I want to ask first is we are having a very big problem here, and the problem we are having is a lot of us, we don't have a passport anymore. They are expired, and when we try to apply for our passport in the embassy, most of us that are in Facebook that are really posting a lot of things about the disintegration of Nigeria, they are refusing us passport in one way or the other, by not even giving us an appointment to get our passport. So, we don't actually know what to do. Some people are running from Germany to Holland to go get their passport and just stuff like that. So, but now most of us don't know on how we go about this thing. So it is a problem. So I don't know how you can clarify these things for us, how we go about it. But a suggestion for it, how I thought, is like, in Germany here, officially in Germany here, we are like not registered officially in Germany here, because like the IPOB Bremen where I belong to, we are registered, and in Europe they have a way their law works. It's like every state have their own law. So as we are registered in Bremen, it's like we are registered under the law of Bremen. The people in Hamburg, who if they are registered in Hamburg, they are registered under the law of Hamburg, the state.
Yes.
And in Cologne, it's just like
it's that. A proper federal system, as you have in the USA, a proper federal system. Every state in Germany has their own laws, and they implement it, they enact their own laws, and they implement it accordingly. It's a proper federal system. I have a very simple answer to your question. There is something called stateless statehood, which means you now have to, what we need to do is to perhaps instruct our lawyers. Mr. Mika is there. Who is our deputy head of the Directorate of State. We can get him to explore the possibility of trying to get the UN involved. And the UN, in this instance, they have no choice. Once you have been denied a renewal of your passport, you go to the nearest UN office or get your lawyer to inquire for you about applying for the status of statelessness, which means somebody without a state until Biafra is recognized. And they are bound by conventions and treaties to make sure that they issue with a travel document. Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, because some of us started this very thing already. Like for me, I went already to the local foreign office where we renew our visa.
Yes.
Let me say where we renew our stay, like those of us who don't have the German passport or something like that. So, and they gave me, because my passport expired already last month, and they gave me something they call in Germany Fiktion Bescheinigung. So this paper I can be using to run around in Germany to work, but I can't use this very paper to leave Germany.
That's what I'm explaining to you. The only document you can use to leave Germany is one issued by the United Nations, because currently we are all stateless. Once the zoo refuses to renew your passport, you become stateless. And with that, it is enough compelling evidence to get the UN to issue you with a travel document, because you are a stateless person. Stateless. That's what it means. And now with it, you can also approach the authorities of where you're in and get them to try to, of course, fix whatever endorsement or should I say, whatever identity or valid document or stay in that very area that you may have to need on your travel document. So the next port of call is the UN, to make them aware that we are stateless, not by choice, but by virtue of the behavior of the Zoological Republic. That's what we are going to do. And I will get Nzulumike to look into it and see how that applies in the case of Germany. That is something that people do not understand. There is something called persons who are stateless, which means you have no country of your own. In our case, we are waiting for Biafra to come. Where you have been denied access to proper documentation, as the zoo is now doing, then we go to the UN and we apply for this very status. As simple as that. And that's what we're going to do. So I will get Nzulumike to investigate it and then come back to us. Because what we have right now, especially in Germany, is not acceptable, and we're not going to accept it. Thank you very much for your call. Is that all you have to say?
Okay, Mazel.
Thank you. Thank you. And remain blessed. Thank you very, very much.